heard. They are behind us. Way down at the foot of the mountain. Stop. Wait for them.
I can't stop on a steep grade like this.
So, Mary, he'll never pull through.
How could such an accident have happened?
I don't believe it. It was an accident.
Is Grant all right? The wagon driver told me. Tex Houston, how'd you get here?
I'll tell you later, Hawkins. We've got to get this man to the wagon train. Look. Indian smoke signals.
What did it say, Tex?
They spotted the wagon train and are signaling the village. Get this man back to the wagon and get started as quickly as possible.
Yes. Are they going to attack us?
I don't know, but I'll soon find out.
Why you stop smoke talk? I tell them better not come. Plenty of white soldiers join wagon train. You know, Sabi? Watch me make smoke talk.
Clean getaway. He'll bring the whole tribe down on the wagon train.
Plenty and all bad.
Heifer, try your wells as fast as you can.
They're coming, huh? How far behind?
I don't know. But get inside that stockade as quickly as possible. What wagon is Grant in?
Mine in the rear.
Thanks.
Indians are coming! Come on!
How is it, Mary?
Not very good, Houston. I'll never last out the journey.
Dad, don't talk like that.
You'll be all right. No. I'm not going to pull through. See that Mary gets to her brother in Gold Creek, will you?
Now, don't you worry. We'll all get through. Help
especially with a sick man aboard.
Say, boss, I got some wages coming. I sure can spend it in here.
All right. But I ought to dock you for losing that wagon.
What are you going to have, boys?
Got a liquor. Maybe some.
Well, dang my hide if there ain't Wolf Moran.
Wolf Moran? I thought the law caught up with him.
He comes from Dodge City where there ain't no law.
Friend of yours, Ben?
Wolf don't have no friends, but his friendship can be had for a price.
Had for a price? That's very interesting.
Hello, Wolf. Glad to see you breathing the free air again.
It's a mighty tight jail to hold me, Ben. What you doing here?
Heading for Gold Creek with that wagon train.
Yeah? I guess any outfit you're with don't aim to dig their gold out of the ground.
Do You're Ben Hollister, who was driving that wagon today when it went over the cliff.
That's me. Sure lucky I didn't go with it.
You sure were. You don't mind telling me how it happened?
Why should I mind? The Doubletree broke at the top of the grade and down she went.
The first time I've ever heard of a Doubletree breaking like that.
There's a lot of things you ain't heard of, Houston. Looks like you were shoving into something that don't concern you.
Ben's getting riled up about something.
Maybe Houston's putting him on the grid. I'll stop that.
What are you driving at, Houston? Sounds like you don't believe the Doubletree broke.
I don't, until I see it. What have you done with it?
Throw it away. What would I do with a broken Doubletree?
Pipe down, Ben. What's all this loud talk about?
Houston here is hinting that I wrecked the wagon on purpose.
Why, that's a ridiculous charge. What possible motive would Ben have for wrecking the wagon with Grant in it?
That's what I'm going to find out.
Houston!
What is it, Reynolds?
Andy Grant just died. Mary's been asking for you.
Sad accident.
If it was an accident.
Reckon Mary would be wanting to see you alone. I'll stay around here a spell.
All right, Reynolds.
Beg pardon, stranger. Did I hear you say the man had just died was named Andy Grant?
Well, yeah.
Would that be Andy Grant of Plainsville?
That's where he hailed from. Did you know him?
No, but I got a letter from his son Tom, Gold Creek, California. What's the tarnation will I do with it now?
You can give it to his daughter, Mary. She's feeling mighty bad, but she'd be glad to hear from Tom.
I ain't no hand to console weeping women. Maybe you'd oblige by giving her the letter.
I feel the same way as you do about weeping women, partner. But I'll tote Tom's letter over to Hawkins, our wagon boss. He'll see that Mary gets it. Say, is it true that Tom struck pay dirt out there?
Pay dirt? He's got the richest mine in Gold Creek.
We've got to get that letter.
Leave it to me. As soon as Reynolds gets outside, I...
Don't be a fool. He knows you and every one of my outfit. This is a job for Ben's friend, Moran. Bring him over to that table.
On your mind?
There's a little job I want done. Well, I better be getting Tom's letter over to Hawkins. Why don't you stop by and see Mary in the morning before you head east?
Maybe you will. So long.
So long.
Now that Father's gone, Mr. Eaton will use that confession to prove that Tom's a thief.
Don't you worry, Mary. We know Tom didn't steal that money. He only wrote that confession to save your father because he thought your father was guilty.
But don't you see? He'll use Tom's confession to force me to marry him.
I know. Then Tom will conveniently die and leave you and Bart Eaton the gold mine.
You don't think he'd kill
Tom? Help! Help! Help!
You wait here, Mary.
Reynolds, who did this?
A tough-looking customer in the checkered shirt. I've heard him call him Moran. He got Mary's letter away from me.
Mary's letter?
Yes, the one from her brother Tom.
Tom?
Which way did he go?
Towards the saloon.
Picked up his head, Mary.
I'll be all right.
Where's Eaton?
Upstairs, room 4.
Hey, you, on the stairs. I'll trouble you for that letter.
Letter?
Oh, yeah.